Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. I hope you all alright and having a good day. We are here today to do some more virtual reality news. It's Sunday, which means only one thing. We wrapping up the whole week, all the biggest news stories in the one video. Everything what you need to know from the world of PSVR, PCVR and Oculus Quest. But before I start... Yes, this is the code, the key for Steam version of Stride. It will also unlock StrideNet, which is your multiplayer version of Stride. You searching for a number, remember the number is missing, not a letter, but a number. It's always a number. So happy guessing, find the number. Of course, whoever is first, then the person won the game. But if you didn't, don't worry, I do daily giveaways pretty much. Okay, so let's get started. Maybe let's begin from Moss Book 2, because I got very excited about this announcement other week. But we've had some more new information and the developer been doing interview and basically what he said is the team for Moss 2 is bigger now, so more people working on the game, which is very nice, but also they said the one biggest complaint about Moss was the gameplay time. The game was too short, so they said the Moss 2 will be much longer. So that's nice, I'm glad they pulled in bigger game. Now, brand new Oculus Quest game got announced, which is called Drum Rock. Tons of virtual reality rhythming game coming out everywhere, left, right and center. So many shitty ones that you just don't want to play them. So some of them are good. I don't know how Drum Rock gonna be, but basically this is your drumming experience. So they're trying to make things different and you'll be killing a monster while bashing the drum. Okay, now moving on to another story. I want to talk about Saints and Sinners Aftershocks, because finally Skydance Interactive gave us updated release date. As we know, the game got delayed, but now we know when it's coming. And it will be with everyone next month on 23rd of September. And that's for all the platform, PlayStation VR, Oculus Quest and PC VR. This is the post-story DLC, so make sure you completed the game and then it will just unlock for you. Okay, another release date we've had was Pistol Whip, Smoke and Thunder. And they said this brand new cinematic Wild Westy style pack for Pistol Whip will be coming on 12th of August, which is just next week, and that will be for PC VR, PlayStation VR and Oculus Quest. Also, with this release on 15th of August, sadly they're gonna increase the price of the game. They said they added a lot of stuff to the game for totally free, but obviously any developer needs to earn money. So what they're doing is the game not gonna cost $25 now, but it's gonna cost $30 from 15th of August. And another release date we've had, and this is quite good one, and this one is for Oculus Quest. I'm talking here about Ven VR Adventure, which is a very nice platformer. I'm already playing the Quest version, I cannot show you much because of embargo, but from what I'm playing, I'm really enjoying it, and definitely it's nice to have those bigger games with more gameplay time on Oculus Quest. That's what Quest just needs. Moving on to the next story, we're coming back to Saints and Sinners, because even though Aftershocks DLC releasing next month, the developers are not done with this game at all, because they said that they planning to make even more DLC in the future. What it's gonna be, I don't know. Judging by their track record, probably it's gonna be for free as well. I know people requesting the co-op mode, but they already said that that's probably not possible because of how the game is designed. But I don't know, stranger things had happened. Also, people want some new areas to explore and bash some brains, the zombies, the walkers. Stab them like this. That's the noise of the brain being squelched with the blunt knife. So yeah, we see what happens. Also, many of you speaking about knives and them being blunt, because of course the weapons got durability. Many of you want this debug mode when you can just become god of the game and switch everything off if you want to. Maybe they're gonna do it. I don't know. But anyway, Saints and Sinners is awesome. Moving on to the another game, I want to talk about Warhammer Age of Sigmar Tempestfall. I love how big of a mouthful is this title of the game. So the developer been doing their little investor report and basically they said the game got release window and it's gonna come out in Q4, so towards the end of this year, probably during holiday season. all of you Warhammer fans will be happy to have it, because of course Warhammer fans are happy to have things. And speaking about things and happiness and also having those, we're gonna talk about the Wizards Dark Times. Many people already have them, this game, because of course it's out. So many people said, okay, here's my money, I have the game. But that you, maybe you paid, but that's not all what you're gonna receive, because the developers working on very cool DLC for the game, which gonna be a co-op mode. So try to get some friends, because you'll be able to play online with your friends. And that's gonna be in Q4, so towards the end of the year. And that of course gonna be for PC VR, but also Quest Owners. Moving on to the next story, let's talk a bit about some PSVR games. I want to talk about Everest Load. Love this game, it's amazing. You just go and just killing, you know what, killing in VR, it looks so real, it's just nice. But many PC players already playing it, it's only early access and it's already awesome. But of course, other people maybe want to play it as well. And the developer was asked about it. Somebody went on Twitter and said, PSVR version planned. And the developer said, yes, we are planning PSVR version. So that's very good news, but before you get too excited, sadly they said it's gonna be a while. So they're not gonna like tell you when, but ages away, so you know, get ready for waiting. And speaking about getting ready and VR games, I like skating. Do you like skating, not waiting? Well, there you have it then. VR Skater, first of all, had update on the PC, which is awesome, I already streamed it. You've got new environments, the building side one is crazy, and also the verticality of it makes it super awesomely amazing. But also, of course, other people want to play this game, and PSVR conjoined with Quest Owners together been asking developer, is this game coming out to our platform? And the developer said, yes, they planning PSVR 2 version, so PSVR 1 won't happen, keep that in mind. And also Quest 2 version, so Quest 1 Owners, that won't happen as well. But nevertheless, VR Skater so intuitive, nice skating game, so it's gonna be nice. I'm assuming PSVR 2, because on PSVR 1 I cannot see how move controllers would work, because you need your hands to do the tricks. And move controllers would be like, losing tracking, I don't know where I am, let's place myself on top of your head. Anyway, moving on to the next story, something for Quest owners this time, and those owners who want to do some racing, because, and like letter Z. Because Z-Race is coming to Oculus Quest, the developer said it's coming very, very soon. And it's gonna release via the App Lab. So not official store, but App Lab, go to their website and you can just download it anyway. So Z-Race is, I didn't play it on PC, I know some people said it's got like a weird ass control system. Some people liked it, some not, I don't know, my comment section been telling me like, I don't know, but anyway. So, but we shall see what the future will hold. Moving on to the future holdings and the future to be seen. The PlayStation VR 2 specs got leaked badly by my friends from PS Without Parole, VR, PSVR Without Parole, Brian down there, the last bastion for PSVR owners, for PSVR only channels. We all moved on to other platforms just to play more VR games, but some people don't want them. They just want to play less VR games. So anyway, let's quickly go through those specs, because they are looking good. The PSVR 2 will have very nice Fresnel OLED lenses, which gonna be 2000x2040 per eye, so 2K per eye, 2K plus 2K, 4K, 110 field of view, the bigger field of view, the better the immersion, of course. Flexible scaling resolution, which apparently gonna improve the performance of the game. Foveated rendering, which gonna improve the performance of the game. Eye tracking, which gonna improve the performance of the game. You see where they going, what they going for. They want to have awesome looking games with some trickery, some console style trickery. It's gonna be great. Also, there will be headset haptics, so you'll be feeling your head being vibrated. The Vibra head, vibration heads vibrate. Also, the controllers will be bundled, of course, but they're gonna have capacitive touch sensors. And they're gonna be a bit different than what you see on Quest and Rift, because they're not only gonna know that you're rubbing the button, but they know how far away from the button your finger is. So, you know, when you're going to finger blast your opponents, the game will know when you're doing actual finger blasting. Also, there's gonna be adjustable IPD and it's gonna vary from 59 to 72 millimeters. Now, I don't know if it's gonna be manual or all software. Of course, electronics now cheaper than actual manual things to be done. So yeah, I'm assuming with combined with eye tracking, the PSVR will just know. Also, the screen will support native 90 and 120 Hz refresh rate. System UI will be superimposed over game. The tracking will be inside-out tracking. As we know, there will be optional VR downloads, and what that means is basically Sony wants to concentrate more on AAA games, but you know, you get two versions. Flatness, pancakey, sad and terrible for flat borderline boring people, but also of course there will be very nice godlike VR mode as well. So apparently there will be some deep dives in Q1 2022. Q1 of course between January and March. So maybe then there's gonna be some bigger reveals, but before that something else might get announced. And speaking about announcements and cool things, we have to talk about Valve, because they teasing brand new headset. As we know, everyone losing their shit over Steam Deck. People seeing Steam Deck and they go, Steam Deck. But also, of course, VR community wants know what they planning for VR. And they was asked about it, you know, with this Steam Deck technology, can they actually do VR? And apparently the developer is said that, yeah, well, this is something what we considering in the future. It's very important towards our future plans, but we're not talking about it yet. So it looks, you know what, Valve might just make standalone VR headset, and that would be pretty, pretty awesome. Okay, so that's it for the wrap-up of the news. What a week for VR. It was amazing week, just like every week, because VR is awesome. Now I want to give shout-out to brand new patron, Damian3K. Thank you very much for your support. I super, super appreciate it. Helps this channel a lot. And of course, shout-out to all the other patrons who makes this channel happen. Thank you very much. You are awesome. And I appreciate your support. And if you want to become a patron, go to patreon.com/polishpolvr, or the link is in the description. From just $1, you can get yourself your eyes on some extra posts and videos down there. Okay, so yesterday I did a news video, believe it or not, and in that news video there is some more virtual reality news, some more about Half-Life Alyx and future of this game, so if you want to check it out, you might just enjoy it. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe and like this subscription. And that's it, bye!